the Lord. Amen. So when the Holy Ghost shows up, God shows up. Amen. So when the Holy Ghost shows up, God shows up. Amen. Glory be to God. So the discerning of spirits, the discerning of spirit. The only way you can discern the spirit, you got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. There's no way you can discern a spirit without having the Holy Ghost, being filled with the Holy Ghost on the inside. You got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm not talking about a touch from the Holy Ghost, because most people say, well, I have a touch. No, you got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. You got to be baptized with fire. My God, in the evidence that you're filled with the Holy Ghost, you got to speak in tongues as the Spirit of God give you utterance. Hallelujah. You are not filled with the Holy Ghost if you are speaking in no tongue. Tongue is the evidence of one being filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That's the evidence according to the Bible. That is the evidence. This is how we know when they are filled with the Holy Ghost. When we hear them speaking in an unknown tongue, then we can say, oh God, she got the Holy Ghost. She been filled with the Holy Ghost. This is how you know when he's filled with the Holy Ghost. When he started to speak in an unknown tongue, and the Spirit of God give him utterance, he's speaking another language. Amen. Then that means he got the Holy Ghost. Glory be to God. Amen. Church of God, it's time for the church to get the Holy Ghost. It's time for the church, the child of God, need to be filled with the Holy Ghost. If you ain't got no Holy Ghost, don't deal with no devil. If you ain't got no Holy Ghost, don't go cast no demon on nobody. Because it is the Holy Ghost that gives you the capability to have dominion over the demons and devil. It's the Holy Ghost. The Bible says in Matthew 10 that Jesus called the disciples, the 12. He called the 12 disciples, and the Bible says he gave unto them power. Come on. He didn't send them out without giving them power. Amen. So if you don't got no Holy Ghost, you ain't need to lay hands on nobody. Because you can impart a demon in that person. If you ain't been filled with the Holy Ghost, don't talk about casting no demon. Sit yourself down until you get filled with the Holy Ghost. Then you deal with the devil. Because you are no match to the devil. For the devil, if you don't have the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. I'm talking about a goosebump. I'm talking where you, I feel the presence. No, I'm talking about the evidence of speaking in tongues. As the Spirit give me words. Amen. This is how I know I was filled with the Holy Ghost. Why? Because I speak in another tongue as the Spirit give me words. I speak in tongues. It don't change. You cannot be filled with the Holy Ghost and don't have a tongue language. If we can go according to the Bible, you got right, my sister. You got to speak in the Holy Ghost, right?
Our father told us if we don't feel it, Holy Ghost, that the path goes to heaven.
That's right. That's your passport. The Holy Ghost. Because Jesus, that's what you needed. Jesus had the Holy Ghost. And you think that you don't need it? The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 4, and Jesus being filled with the Holy Ghost was led. Come on. Jesus got the Holy Ghost and churches denying the Holy Ghost. Oh, I got the Holy Spirit. I got it. And he got a bit of tongue. Never speak in tongue. You ain't got no Holy Ghost if you're speaking tongue. The evidence of one being filled is speaking in tongue. Until I hear the tongue, you ain't got no Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hey, this is not no just word of mouth. No, I want to hear the tongue. The apostle them lay hands on them and they begin to speak in tongue. You know what the Bible said? Let's go to Acts 19. Let's go to Acts 19. Amen. Expose the devil. Expose him. Amen. Expose him. They're telling you that the Holy Ghost was for that time. What time they're talking about? I want to know what time they're talking about. Oh, the Holy Ghost. wasn't for that time, this time, no, the devil's a liar. Amen. The last time I checked, the Bible says he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus never changed. Glory be to God. Amen. And the church needs the Holy Ghost. The church needs to be baptized. Amen. With the fire. Amen. That's why we got weaklings in the church, because there ain't no power. Come on, somebody. It takes a higher power to undo a power. Amen. You can't cast no devil out with no power. Amen. Amen. In Acts chapter 19, amen. In Acts chapter 19, you're gonna see that Paul came in encounter with some of John the Baptist's disciples. Amen. Let's start from verse 2. Acts chapter 19. Let's start from verse. Yeah.
Have ye received the Holy Ghost since ye believed?
Okay, so these disciples was believers. Mm-hmm. And so Paul said, do you receive the Holy Ghost since you what? Believe. So they was believers, but they didn't have the Holy Ghost. Amen. And what did they say?
And they said unto him.
And this is what a lot of churches saying right now. This is what there's a lot of churches saying right now.
We have not so much as heard.
See, the pastor ain't teaching about the Holy Ghost. So the members, they didn't know that they need the Holy Ghost. Because the pastor's not preaching the whole Bible.
Whether there be any Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
And he said unto them. Unto what then? Were ye baptized?
Okay, in other words, what baptism you was baptized under? And what did they say?
And they said unto John's baptism.
My God.
Then said Paul.
Uh-huh.
John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance.
Okay.
Saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him.
Uh-huh.
That is on Christ Jesus.
Amen.
When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus.
They was baptized in the what?
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
In the name of the Lord Jesus. When they heard it, they was baptized in the Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
And when Paul had laid his hands upon them.
When Paul laid his hands upon them, what happened?
The Holy Ghost came upon them.
Now, watch it now. The Holy Ghost came upon them. Yeah. And what was the evidence? What is the evidence?
And they spake with other tongues.
And they spake with what?
Other tongues.
So when somebody has been filled with the Holy Ghost, what is the evidence?
Tongues.
Okay.
Amen.
Okay. If they ain't speaking in tongues, they ain't filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
And prophesy.
Glory be to God. Amen. Hallelujah. When I got filled with the Holy Ghost, amen, many years ago in a prayer meeting, amen, I mean, I just speak in tongues. It just come naturally. Yeah, I can't even control my tongue. What I did, I exercise it. You got to exercise it. Some people speak with it once and they leave it alone.
Amen.
No, that's your heavenly language. You got to pray with it every day. You have to exercise that. Amen. Amen. You exercise that. That is not just for one-time experience. No. No. Amen. That is your most holy faith. Amen. Praying in the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen. He that speaketh not in unknown tongues, speaketh not unto man, but howbeit no man understood him. In the spirit he speak mystery. Glory be to God. Amen. How are we going to be able to discern familiar spirit and we have not yet received the Holy Spirit?
Okay.
You can. See, the problem is we try to use our senses. Your senses cannot pick up demonic spirits. Amen.
Okay.
And a lot of them is in the church. A lot of familiar spirits in the church, you know. Everywhere you go, there's a familiar spirit.
Yeah.
How do you know what a familiar spirit in you?
That's a good
How do you know when if you got it from being the Spirit? It is a yes, sir, it's possible. Because if you ain't got the Holy Spirit, if you ain't got the Holy Ghost, what you think you get?
From being the Spirit.
Okay. That will make you think you got it when you don't. That's a spirit of deception and lying. Make you think you got it and make you think you don't need it. Now watch it now. What really make a witch a witch?
Not the broom.
Not the broom and not the black hat. What really make them a witch is a demonic spirit called a familiar spirit that operates in that person. And how do these spirits get in people? I can go through some of the ways how unclean spirit can get in you. Amen. There's many ways that it can get in into you. It cannot get in a believer, because the believer is protected. Now watch some of the behavior.